When you're in the public eye, people think you're different.
People think you're different.
Truth is, I want what everyone wants.
Love.
My ideal guy would be somebody that hasn't really seen that much, because I have, and I'd like to see through him.
I just didn't believe in the fairy tale.
I care about you. If you ever watch this tape, I care.
This is my journey.
Well, you tell me how you really feel all the time.
No, I don't.
You don't even have to say it. I can see it in your eyes.
I'm real, and I'm just gonna tell you like it is.
This is my journey.
Think that you're scared to love me, and that makes me scared to love you.
Our journey. Is it just the sex?
The kisses are really good. The sex is really good. My love doesn't scare me. Other people's love scares me.
Britney is hardened.
We're gonna not use this. I'm being serious.
We're using it.
They look like boobs, but they're not. They're my knees. They're my knees. I have the coolest hotel room in the whole world. Here's my dining room, my freaking kitchen over here. The States need to have more hotels like this. Or maybe I'm just more popular over here. Here's my bed. See my view? And flowers in the yellow. Here's my closet. And the best part in the whole thing, I got a piano over there. And it's really big. See, I told you guys that I'm spoiled and I gotta share it with you because it's a little much just for one little person like me.
I was on the road for a while and I think I was missing my family and I had a camera to amuse myself, kind of lonely at the time. So I think there was a little void.
I'm gonna figure out how to do Zoom, y'all. Hold on. Doing it now, okay.
Right now, we're talking about commitment and relationships and what we think are, when's the timing right, like in marriage and that whole thing. What do you think about commitment, Laurentius?
I think I'm into a committed relationship. But I don't believe too much in marriage, except that it means free healthcare, that yes.
Free healthcare. Honestly, okay, I don't believe in marriage either. I mean, I've been married, but that was a different story.
Are we fixing it?
Yeah, I hope so. It is working on it.
Cool. What do you think about marriage?
I've done it twice, so...
See?
Alright.
Twice.
That's funny.
Why, you getting married?
Handsome lad, like...
No, I've been there, done that.
Done it?
Yeah. No, I did it, like, in a...
I don't know what I did.
Oh, yeah, you read about it.
Yeah, everyone loves it. Everyone read about it.
Oh. Okay, Fee, what do you think about commitment and marriage?
I don't feel like I've been ready before this minute. And, you know, I really haven't met anybody that I just can't live without. So I think that when I do, I definitely want to get married.
Well, Felicia is my assistant. But she's not just my assistant. She's my friend. She's my everything. And I love her a lot.
What do you want your dream guy to be like, Fee?
Very rich.
really care about money. I want him to be happy with himself. I would like for him to be younger just because I like younger guys.
Call 1-800-642. You know what? Voice your wishes and continue to do that and it'll be out there.
That's what I'm hoping.
I really don't know why I was asking so many questions about commitment and marriage.
Hello.
Maybe because I hadn't had that in so long. It's something I kind of longed for, and trying to shout out to the universe, come to me in some weird way.
Hi. My ideal guy, I think, for me, would be somebody that's cool and is not really fazed by that much stuff and hasn't really seen that much, because I have, and I'd like to see through him all over again. And kind of sweet and nice, and that loves me a lot. And that's really it. It's kind of love. I don't care what they look like. I just want them to be.
Well, I do care a little bit what they look like. I don't want to be face ugly.
What about you, Laurentius? What's yours?
Rich man.
A rich man? Yeah. You like the rich guys, huh?
Uh-huh.
Okay, we're going to TRL right now. I'm getting in the car. Hi! We're 5 minutes away now from TRL! Yeah! And we're going there, and it's gonna be fun. But you gotta film it, Fee. Okay.
Hi.
I'm okay.
TRL, you okay?
TRL.
And look who showed up on the show. Britney Spears, she's running towards us all. This must be Total Request Live.
Total Request Live.
I haven't had a date in a while, so can you inspire me, like, in your audience with a lot of cute guys? I think that's essential. So essential. Please.
TRL UK.
You are indeed.
Okay, Britney's getting ready to go out onto TRL.
Today, Miss Britney Spears.
Her Starbucks has kicked in.
She has bought the UK exclusive of a brand new video. She's the star. Please bring us together. For Miss Britney Spears! We're gonna get in the zone!
Yeah!
What do you think of English, guys?
I think your accent's really hot. I like it.
Thank you very much. Got big hair to go with it. We're going to enjoy for the first time ever in the UK, every time, your brand new video.
Yes.
Okay? There's a few.
Oh, now Big Mo is in my way. Ain't a lens big enough for those two. Being in the public eye, you know, they have their own way of projecting you and what they want the world to think of you as what you're like. But I think I'm just like anybody else, you know. I long for love and companionship and friends and all of those things, you know.
Every time I try to fly, I fall without my wings. I feel so small. I guess I need you, baby.
Teresa, how do you feel about marriage and commitment?
Yeah, I want to get married one day, but I'd like to have a boyfriend first.
Sonny.
Mm-hmm.
What do you feel about commitment and marriage?
Why are you whispering?
I don't know.
Because people change, I don't necessarily know if I believe so much in marriage anymore.
I don't either.
Love is like the biggest mystery to me.
Girl, you're not sure. I'm bitter.
I'm bitter Betty here too.
Yeah.
That's all good.
We'll be bitter Betty's together.
Together.
I think because I hadn't had a relationship in a really long time, I was very much bitter Betty, but I think talking it out to your girlfriend can kind of justify and create what you want, you know, in the future.
Thank you, guys.
Anytime.
I needed some companionship. And for some reason, I couldn't get this guy out of my head that I'd met.
What's your favorite sex position?
I don't like one position.
Ah, hell no!
Mom, just ignore this whole part! You just don't know what you're getting yourself into.
You know, this film could end up anywhere. Don't ask me anything about sex. And you shut up.
I'm not all about sex, y'all. Today is what do you think about commitment and marriage? See, I think society places
it's
too much emphasis. No, it is not the same. It is not. I can't believe you just said that, Mike. End of story. End of conversation. There's a cute guy on the tour, and he's really supposedly like really really cool and stuff. His name's McGill. What, Faye?
Miguel.
We're gonna try to hook the shizmalls up, and she can get some smashles going on in the head. So.
I definitely think there's a time in every woman's life, if you haven't had companionship, or you should let go, and be your hot mama self. And, you know, do your thing. Yeah.
Felicia and Miguel.
Felicia is like the sweetest thing in the world. Having that type of thing with Felicia is forbidden.
Felicia and Miguel.
I'll tell her right now.
Sometimes I think people need to put a little bug in someone's ear just to kind of put it out there that it's okay, or to just open them up a little bit to a different horizon.
Smashels, V, you need to get laid. You do, because sometimes you get on our nerves, right?
Well, that doesn't have anything to do with me getting on your nerves.
No, but sometimes you need a Valium, and you need to get laid. You need to come back glowing. Not, no, you don't get on our nerves, but you do need to, you need to get laid.
Oh my God.
That was my mission with Felicia.
Here we go, and you guys are gonna get to see my peeps in the hizio. That door there, Isabel. In the elevator. Let's get crazy. Here are the people. They're all here for me, man. Ha! Sorry.
I think being overseas, the audiences are definitely more uninhibited. They are crazy. When I walk out in the crowds, I'm not really nervous because I've done it for so long. I'm really excited. I feel like it's my birthday every day. You know, you go out there and, I mean, 9 million people screaming your name. It's surreal.
You like the way I move, huh? I don't need to do what I feel like doing, so let me go. Just listen. All you people look at me like I'm a little girl. Well, did you ever think it'd be okay for me to step into this world? Always say a little girl, don't step into the world. Well, I'm just trying to find out why, cause dancing's what I love. Just got
guys in my bus.
It's really cool. It's different because it's overseas and stuff.
I wish this thing would open up a little bit more so I could zoom or something like that. Anyways, I'll figure it out later. Oh, I did do something. Whoa, here we go. Anyways, this is all my food area part right here. I'm getting the hang of the whole camera situation. Ta-da! Walk over this way. Ow. And you feel like you're in a home. It's kind of low to the ground. But this is my favorite part. I got stars on my ceiling. I used to pay a lot of money for stars when I was little, but they're already done for me. Yeah. There's paparazzi taking pictures of me down there, if you can see them. They're right there. Taking a damn picture of me. Stupid people. People can take everything away from you, but they can never take away your truth. But the question is, can you handle it? Can you handle my truth? Can you? I don't know. Can you handle hers? And his? We shall see. Pretty glitter over there. It's really cool. And Isabel puts it on me and she makes my eyes really, really, really pretty.
She gotta look flawless.
She say flawless.
Flawless.
Yes.
The concept of today is, what is your favorite sex position? Thank
you. Okay, so what's yours?
Oh God, there are just so many. You know, pretty much whichever way I get it, I like it.
Okay, what's your favorite sex position?
I guess it depends on who it's with.
What's your favorite sex position?
Beggars can't be choosers. Any way I can get it.
Is everyone answering this?
Everybody's answering it.
Oh my God, why are you asking me that? I haven't had sex in a long time.
What is your favorite sex position?
I can't believe you got me sitting here, you little.
You're so cute!
Johan, that's cool.
Now Felicia's turn. No, face in the chair. Felicia and Kalada. She wants to Flada. Why did I just say that? Okay. Okay. What is your favorite sex position?
I don't know. I've never done it before.
That was really lame. That was lame. Mo, what's your favorite sex position?
The bedroom.
The what?
The bedroom.
The bedroom. That's kind of sweet. He said the bedroom. JC, you're cool. You're sexy, hot, yes. Okay, Okay, the question is, what's your favorite sex position?
Dude, I am not answering
that. Get your ass in here!
JC was there on tour with me because he was opening up for me overseas. But I knew him from a long time ago because he used to be in a group called NSYNC. I don't know if anybody knows who that group is.
No, you have to answer. JC, you have to answer.
I'm not like that. I don't like one position. I'm a bad boy.
You like them all?
I don't like them all, but I like
Look
a lot.
Look at him running, y'all. He's scared.
I'm definitely scared of you.
But okay.
You're not supposed to know this.
No, JC, come on. There's got to be one that you like.
I like a lot of them.
All of them.
Not all of them, but a lot of them.
A lot of them.
JC was shy. I wasn't expecting him to be that shy, but it was kind of cute.
We need to know from you, what is your favorite position?
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Mom, just ignore this whole part. Alrighty? And Dad, too. And Jamie Lynn, too. Okay. Right now, I'm getting ready for my show. Hi.
Hi.
Everybody says hi.
Hello.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah,
hello.
Hello in the mirror. This is weird. We're looking at ourselves in the mirror. I look like a cone head.
Hello.
We took my some extensions out of my hair. It's girl, I know. And we took the extensions out, and my hair is like, I have none. What if I went on stage like that? Or like this? Hi, everyone. I'm Brittany. I just want to say
and I'm part of
I am awesome. Oh, my God.
God. I'm like so cool. Watch.
I know this. Will you be free from your worries? What a fun filled fantasies. Keep you on your toes.
Bye.
Bye.
I'll see you out there.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
No, I am a wild ass girl.
I welcome you to the Onyx Hotel.
Are you ready?
Omar. Yes. We're rolling. Here we go, gentlemen.
Going to my show now. Hi, Johanna.
Have a good show.
Thank you. Tour for a while and I was having a lot of fun, but I realized that there was this huge void and I met this guy earlier in LA, so I thought, why not just bring him to London with me?
You drive me crazy. I just can't sleep. I'm so excited. I'm in too deep. Oh.
Told me, she was like, I'm not going on tour unless you go with me.
Camera shy, too.
That's why we like him.
Pack your bags, get your passport.
He doesn't want to stay. Why don't you want to stay, Kevin? Well, there was this guy that I'd met in the States, and I couldn't get him out of my head.
Well, I was living with my best friend from back home. We usually always hit this Monday night place, you know, Joseph's.
I was in LA, and I went out one night. I had my groove on that night, and I thought I looked kind of hot.
You know, it was just a regular night. You know, just like any other night that you go out and didn't expect anything. Britney was there.
I saw Kevin there. I just knew.
And a couple of her dancers introduced us. That was it.
He was very, very mysterious. He just seemed not fazed by anything. And just his whole vibe was really sexy. I like that.
She wound up dancing with me that night for a couple of minutes, maybe, seconds, maybe. That's how it started. We just started talking to each other and getting to know each other from that point, and I don't know, magic happened.
Welcome to London. We hope you enjoyed your flight.
There we go. Now we can see. Okay, I want to introduce you guys to my friend, Kevin. He wants to leave. He just got here.
I'm gone. All right.
She did it, man. She said it. She told me. She was like, I'm not going on tour unless you go with me.
God, I'm camera shy, too, so.
That's why we like him.
No.
Said you're coming with me, honey. So pack your bags, get your passport, and get on the damn plane. He doesn't want to stay, and it's really hurting me. Why don't you want to stay, Kevin?
You know what?
Yes, I do.
Your hour starting to tell me to leave. See what time it is?
There is a clock right there. Ew, ew. No, you're the one who said you were leaving.
No, you said told me to leave.
Okay, we're in the discussion. We're not going to talk about it anymore. We're going to go look at the park.
I was here for an hour, and she's asking me, when are you leaving?
I'm just
was playing.
I felt wanted. And I wanted to be with her, too. And it was like, we didn't know. We didn't know each other. We knew each other for 5 or 6 days. And that was it.
And here's cute Kevin. He's so cute. Hi. Kevin, we have to ask you a question.
Oh, God, here we go.
How do you feel about marriage and commitment?
I feel that... I feel that love is love. Love is a commitment. I don't believe in marriage.
Okay.
Well, I believe you can get married.
I think I'd ask so many people about it, and the obvious thing for me to do would be not to do that if you like the person, so I kind of was playing reverse psychology. I don't like you, so I'm gonna ask you about marriage, you know? So I think that's why I probably did all that, which really screwed me because I ended up falling for him even more, so.
Love, it is what it is. You don't need a certificate telling you that you love somebody. You don't need, you know, anything like that. I don't need a ring to make me feel like, oh, I'm closer to her or I'm closer to this person. It's not like that. Love is, it is what it is. It's everything. Everything.
My question is now, what makes it different when you're with one girl and then another, like when you have sex? So what is it? What's the difference? What makes it good?
It makes it good when you have feelings. It's not just sex. But I mean, it gets deeper than that. It's more mental.
Walked out of the room. She's like, okay, tell me what you think. Isn't he nice? Isn't he cute? I'm like, yes, yes. He's a really great guy and he's a good dancer. You gotta see him dance.
When I first saw him, I'm like, this guy's just out here for a free ride. I don't like the way he looks.
I'm getting it on camera, abuse right here.
I don't like the way he walks. I don't like the way he wears clothes, his hair. There was nothing I liked about Kevin the first day I met him.
Get that damn camera on my face.
It was the big brother in me.
I don't know if I was liking it.
How do you get a night shot? There we go. Cool. There we go. Ah!
We're a little tipsy right now.
What do you think about Eminem?
I think he's a genius.
He's a genius, but he complains a lot, but that's cool.
Well, I don't know personally, but...
Because it's cool when guys complain about things that girls have done to them and or their mothers. I personally think it's kind of, but it's like... But hey, whatever gets you in the game, right? And gets you out there. That's cool. It's controversy. That's what they all want. That's what they want to see. It's how good you can play the game. So, but we're talking about marriage and stuff like that earlier. And the person that I'm going to marry, I think I would like to marry, I'm not going to marry this person, is Brad Pitt. I think he's going to fall in love with a young girl in like 5 years. And yeah, I think he's going to get really bored. So that's the person, that's my ideal. Like, that's what I want to happen. Okay, if you could marry anybody and like the finest celebrities in the whole world, who would you marry? Like right now, if you had to choose somebody.
None of y'all.
I'm just kidding. I'm just...
Okay. Our sex is so good. Hi!
That is not funny at all.
Well, I could not come in here.
Because I was having sex. Ecstasy, ecstasy, ecstasy.
Payback is a bitch. Do you like the way I rock it? Boy, it's chaotic.
It's a rainy, dreary day here in London. It's really kind of gross outside. It's been raining. Kevin's taking a shower. I just talked to my mom on the phone. This is our cool room. There's too many damn pictures around us where it makes you dizzy. That's a hot picture. I wonder what it means. Everyone has their own interpretation of what things mean to them. My interpretation of this would probably be a lady on top of the world. And she's in love with that guy right there with the arrow. But he may break her heart and put something through it. And the little person down there is her fairy trying to help her. Not make her fall so hard to get hurt. That was my interpretation. Right now, I'm waiting on Kevin. He needs to really hurry up.
Wait, I thought you said 4:00.
No, we gotta go now because I'm going to the sun tinted bed. We're going early.
Oh, see?
Come on.
I'm coming.
Let's go.
Okay. Why are you taping me?
Because you're sexy.
No. You.
Let's don't go. Let's just all day. And then, yeah. Okay.
I mean, you know I'm down for that idea, actually.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to my stage right now. Hi! Woo! We're at sound check right now, and I'm about to... Every time.
If you can tell the color and stuff, it looks so pretty.
That room is cool. It's like pink and...
Well, I could not come in here.
Because I was having sex.
Not in here?
Yes, in here.
No.
Yes.
How many times did you do that?
I'm quick. I'm bam bam. Thank you, Bill.
No, but hello. How many times today? No. Just because you were sweating.
No.
Oh.
Hello.
Oh my
God. It's a wonderful thing.
Oh my God.
Ready? Let's go.
Anything I've ever really dreamt of, I'll put my mind to it and I'll kind of make it happen. But with Kevin, I didn't know. Was he the one? I think I was scared. Stay tuned for scenes from our next episode. Take a peek at next week. Everything depends on the magic in a kiss.
The kisses are great.
I like her.
I'm hiding behind the camera. I'm really getting a feel for who you are.
I don't know what you're thinking.
I don't know what you're thinking.
Is that what scares you?
I've never really liked anybody. When he came along, it was kind of like, what the hell?
A young lady that's sitting on top of the world, very rich, you're gonna be concerned. And that I was.
I think there's a little tension at first.
I don't want this punk around her. I'm getting rid of him.
No, Mom, no, stop, y'all. No.
Yeah.
everybody is getting wild. I'm on fire, oh, I'm on fire. Look at this one. Do you like the